He has been part of MSNBC's nightly lineup since the beginning of the year, trying out for a permanent slot. Cenk Uygur, known online as one of the Young Turks, is a two-fisted liberal who isn't afraid to throw some punches.
When they tell you it's broke, they are lying, lying, lying. The problem is they've already spent that surplus on tax cuts for the rich. Those are the guys that are sucking off of you. So here's something else they should suck on. A rage.
The right answer was to fight. The right answer was to kick the Republican ass.
Uygur says his network bosses talked to him about his delivery, and when he refused to change his style, this week they parted company, but not before he took a few shots at MSNBC.
I got pulled in, and they told me, hey, listen, it was actually one specific person, the head of MSNBC. He said, I was just in Washington, and people in Washington tell me that they're concerned about your tone.
And Cenk Uygur joins me now from Los Angeles. Welcome. You referred right there to Phil Griffin, the president of MSNBC. What did you think he meant when he asked you to tone it down?
Well, we're having the conversation, and he said, I talked to people in Washington, and they were concerned about your tone. And in the beginning of the conversation, I was thinking, that's kind of a weird way to put something. What does he mean? His friend Bob in Washington? Does he mean one of the reporters? What does he mean? But as the conversation unfolded,
he meant other MSNBC staffers.
Well, that's what he claims, but okay. I find that I'm incredulous about that, because the rest of the conversation was, hey, look, Cenk, we'd love to be outsiders. Outsiders are cool, but we're insiders. We're the establishment, and you have to act like it. Now, if my bookers had problems with my waving my arms, that would be an incredibly weird way of putting that.
But you suggested when the split came that perhaps there was some White House pressure on MSNBC because you have taken on the president on various things, but you don't have any evidence of that, do you?
But I didn't say that. I said people in Washington had a concern with my tone, which is what Phil Griffin told me. I didn't say that he said that it was the White House. Now, you know, who's the people in Washington? I think that's a really great question. Probably needs some more investigation. You know, a friend of mine just suggested that I watch a 60 Minutes piece from a couple of months ago on Al Sharpton, and I found that to be very curious, because Leslie Stahl said there, and here I have the quote for you, Sharpton says he's decided not to criticize the president about anything. So the guy who was criticizing the president is out, even though he had really good ratings, and the guy who has decided not to criticize the president about anything is in. That's interesting.
MSNBC in talks with Al Sharpton to take over that 6 p.m. Show, and that probably will happen. Let me read you the MSNBC statement. I know you've seen this. Cenk's claims are completely baseless. In fact, we were working on a new contract to develop him into an even bigger television talent. We did have numerous conversations with Cenk about his style, not substance. It's unfortunate that he's decided to depart in such a negative fashion. There was an offer on the table for you to remain a contributor and do a weekend show. You chose not to do that. What about this notion that you just decided to go negative and rip them?
All right. Well, look, here's the thing. They say it's baseless, except they don't specify what's baseless about it. They have already acknowledged that that conversation took place. They just say, oh, that insider-outsider conversation, we meant your producer said that, which, again, does not seem credible at all, right? So they've actually acknowledged every single part of the story, so I don't know what they're saying is baseless.
Okay,
and second of all, yes, there was a lot of money on the table. I'm not a rich guy. I got a Pontiac Grand Am from 10 years ago. The air conditioning doesn't work. Look, I thought about the money a lot, but I told my agent, that's it, we're done. I don't want to take it. And the deciding factor was, look, I got to tell this story. Our media is obsessed with access. It's not just MSNBC, and it's not personal. Look, I think CNN does it. So Fox News is a propaganda outfit entirely. And we're all worried, oh, my God, are the politicians going to come on? Our job is supposed to challenge the politicians, challenge the government. That's what the press is supposed to do.
Well,
and I don't think we're doing it.
For my part, I see people who I agree with and disagree with on Fox, on MSNBC, on CNN, challenging the government every night. So it does kind of come back to your tone. I've watched you. You're a passionate guy. You can be pretty strident at times. Don't your employers, if you're going to work for an MSNBC, have every right to say your style needs some adjustment? Why does that tick you off so much?
No. Look, if it's just a matter of style, I hear you. Like, for example, they say, you know, you should act like a senator on TV. I don't agree with that, but hey, I work for them, so I tried to listen to that as much as I could, right? If I thought it was about style and, hey, don't wave your hands or this or that, you think I'm going to turn down all of that money when I really, really need it because I didn't agree with their stylistic
but
points
just
of view.
To be absolutely clear,
a speech
Cenk,
about being an insider. That's not about style. That's about substance.
Anybody, other than saying you should have more Republicans on as guests, did anybody say you should moderate in any way your political positions?
Well, that was the certainly the sense that I got from it. They were concerned that we're too aggressive against Democrats. I was certainly the most aggressive against President Obama. No question about that. You can see that in all the tapes. And I think President Obama is not remotely progressive, and that's a message that, you know, I'm pretty sure that the White House does not like to hear as they're heading into an election. And look, Howard, if I thought it was about style, I'm not turning down the money. It was about substance. They say, be the establishment. I can't be the establishment. I got to tell people the truth, which is that the Democrats and the Republicans are here to screw you. Look, they're about to cut Social Security.
All right.
They're about to cut taxes on the rich. It's insanity. And who on the air is saying it?
I've got half a minute.
And, you know, to
after
your point
you were,
about challenging, I don't see it.
I got half a minute. After you were asked to tone it down, you, in fact, kicked it up and went back to your more expressive styles. You were kind of giving MSNBC a finger in the eye.
Look, when they tell me, hey, you got to be an insider and watch your tone, I think I'm not going to do that. And if you want to hire me, great. If you don't want to hire me, okay, well, this is what happens. There's no problem with that. You made your choice. I'm not. MSNBC is making the choice that they're making. I'm making I don't want to work for an organization that says, hey, take it easy on Washington.
You have
That's
made that clear.
That's the opposite of what we do on the Young Turks.
Thanks very much. Maybe we'll have you back since you're now liberated. And still to come on this program,